Hi, today in this demo video series, I will be talking about how to deploy containers on AWS without any container orchestrator knowledge. So let's start at a very high level and start working down on what we've heard from customers, as well as developers who want to focus on app development but face many challenges which limits their productivity. Firstly, they would like to innovate and focus on applications on their code to be able to build value-added services and products on top of AWS. Secondly, they want to do this in a way that allows them to scale far beyond what they would be able to do so on their traditional on-premises data centers, so they want to be able to scale out and scale in very quickly. And of course, this whole process has to be painless and seamless. Lastly, security is very important, so they want to be developing and operating in a very secure manner. So let's take a look at App Runner's building blocks of what's under the hood. At the top here, you see the application coming out of either a container registry like ECR public or ECR private, or it can even be a source code repository, something like GitHub or Bitbucket. Sitting underneath that is App Runner. With App Runner, you don't have to manage any clusters, like load balancing, things like auto-scaling, observability, as well as the CI/CD, among many other things. These are all handled by App Runner under the hood. Your only job here is to focus on building out your application, and App Runner takes care of the rest. So there are a few benefits and use cases which I'll briefly go through here. The first benefit, of course, is ease of use. With App Runner, you can build and run web applications at scale in a way that's not going to require you to re-platform and change architecture at each step of their progression. With App Runner, we abstract the infrastructure away from you, so there are no VPCs to operate. The networks are handled and abstracted by AWS, and the same goes with the servers, as well as the CI/CD pipelines. There are also no orchestrator technologies to learn, like ECS or EKS, and this leads to a drastic reduction in your time to market for new applications and features. Secondly, is flexible deployment. From a deployment perspective, we provide flexibility. You have the option here to either deploy directly out of a Git repository, or if you have already heavily invested in containers, you can continue to do so as well. From this demo, I'm going to deploy directly from a container registry. So while App Runner is providing the option to build applications, you don't have to do it through App Runner itself. You may already be using Jenkins or GitLab or a variety of other CI/CD pipelines. You can, of course, keep those as it is, push your images into ECR as the last step, and then App Runner can watch the ECR repository, grab the tag image, and be able to deploy that for you. In terms of use case, some of the more common application use cases that are best suited to run on App Runner include front-end and back-end web or mobile applications, and this allows you to run thousands of microservices simultaneously, including API services, back-end web services, websites, and more. App Runner applications also support container images in any languages, as well as runtimes and web frameworks, including Node.js and Python. So for today's demo, we will be using two services, AWS ECR, which is the container registry, as well as AWS App Runner to actually run your application. Now, let's move into the demo. Hi, so welcome back to the demo. First things first, you're going to have to create a repository. I have already created one, it's called demo video. And this is where you're going to be pushing your images into the repository. You can also view the push commands here, where it gives you necessary steps that you can do to actually authenticate to the ECR service and be ultimately be able to push your own images into ECR itself. So first things first, I'm going to authenticate to ECR. Basically what it does is that it uses the AWS CLI and then it performs a Docker login based on your credentials. And this allows you to push your images into ECR. So since I've already built my image and it's already cached locally, I'm just going to push the image into ECR. It's going to be a relatively quick process because it's already built and pushed before. All the layers are already cached. So once you refresh this, you're going to see the image appear within the repository itself. So now you are going to use this image and deploy it within App Runner itself. Let's go over to the App Runner console. So once you're in the App Runner console, you can create a service. And when you're on this landing page, you basically have two options, right? You could either deploy it via a container registry, or you could use a source code repository. So some of the source code repositories are providers that we have enabled within App Runner itself. It's GitHub and also Bitbucket. But for today, I'm going to show you the container registry option. So you could do it either, you could deploy images either from ECR private or ECR public repositories, and of course I just use private, so I'm going to use the ECR private ones. Select your image repository, it's the demo video one, and then the tag, image tag will automatically populate because there's only one image within it. Next, scroll down to the deployment settings. You basically have two options, either manual or automatic. I'm going to select the automatic ones. And what it means is that every time I push a new image into the repository, it's going to look out for a certain tag, and then it's going to deploy the image in App Runner or update the application in App Runner for you automatically. And for it to do so, it will need to have access or permissions to ECR itself. And that's why you need to create a new service role. I have already created one, so I'm just going to use the existing role. So go on to the next page. You're going to give your App Runner service a name. I'm just going to call it Demo Video Service. And you have the option to choose the capacity or the amount of resources you want to give to the App Runner application itself. By default, it's going to be 1 vCPU and 2 GB MEM. But of course, this is something that you can configure based on your own application needs. So the port I'm going to use is 8080. Again, this is something that you can configure on your own. And you have the option to do things like auto-scaling configurations. You could determine the minimum size that you want, the maximum size you want it to auto-scale it up to. And also the amount of concurrency requests that your App Runner application can take at any one time. You can also configure a health check where you have two protocols to choose. You could either choose a TCP protocol, or if you have a certain path within the application, you could choose the HTTP health check. So in terms of security, if your application needs to have access to other AWS services like S3 or DynamoDB or RDS, you will need to grant your application a role with the necessary IAM policies and permissions attached to that role. But since I do not have that within my application, I'm just going to leave it as blank. You could also configure encryption using AWS own keys, or you can upload your own keys into KMS and use those keys as encryption keys within your application. So I'm just going to leave the rest as default, and I'm going to click on next. Review your configurations, and then if everything's okay, you can just scroll down to create and deploy. So now this is going to take several minutes to actually come up. As you can see here, it returns your default domain. This is where you're going to access your application on from. You can also look at the source where you can see that it's actually referencing an ECR private repository. And you can also look at the App Runner event logs itself. So you can look at the deployment logs to see if everything is created properly. And once the application is up, you can also look at the application logs and this interface as well. Of course, you can view all of this on CloudWatch if you want to as well. So now we're going to give this a while. If this is currently operation in progress, it's going to turn to a running state. If it does not turn green, it means that something is wrong has happened, either on the application level, and you will have to go through the logs and troubleshoot to see what is wrong with it. So now let's give it a while, and we'll come back when this turns green. And here, now you've successfully deployed your App Runner service itself. You can see that it's up and running. There are no errors here. And now when you click on this default domain, it actually routes you to your application itself. So here we go. You have successfully pushed the image into ECR and deployed that image into App Runner itself. So with this deployment, you realize that you do not have to handle any of the underlying networking things like VPC. There's no CI/CD process which you have done within AWS itself. And there's no auto-scaling which you need to configure. All of this is done under the hood for you. And the only thing you need to do is to specify the image, push it in ECR, and then create the App Runner service. And here we go, we have a live application. Thanks for watching. This is a demo video on how to easily deploy your containers on AWS. Till next time.